Like, picture like the tank rifle. Picture, like, the tank rifle in this game. You just roll up with one of those, like, 80 pounds.
A Desert Eagle 50 cal.
Fucking 50 cal.
The dumbest security footage I've ever seen. A guy walked into a gas station with one of those, like, Vietnam-era, like, China Lake grenade launchers.
What the
fuck? Loaded in the store.
What the fuck did he get in China Lake?
And fucking, you hear this garbled over the CCTV. It's like, yes, for like all the bags of Fritos there. And the guy looks at him like, are you fucking kidding me?
Maybe he was just really, really stoned.
Like, no, if it was Ruffles, it would make sense, but like Fritos.
You shut your mouth. Fritos are fucking fantastic.
Oops. Hello there, and welcome to Giant Shadow, which really should be called Tank Hunter Heaven, because if you happen to have the sniper rifle that fires rounds the size of a school bus and looks like it could kill a T-Rex, you're basically unstoppable.
Blam! Dead! Blam! Dead! Blam! Dead!
And I'm not gonna lie to you and say that I always camp the Tank Hunter spawn, but my team always manages to avoid it like syphilis, so I'm happy to pick it up. Now, if you haven't already heard what every YouTuber has been saying about this new map, allow me to give you a brief summary in the form of a terrible free-to-play MMORPG chat spam.
Holy shit! Holy shit! Holy shit! Holy shit! Holy shit! Holy shit! Oh my god!
Just to get the formalities out of the way, the crossbow is kinda neato, but it's not at all what you're expecting, because in reality, it's just another gadget that offers you shit to aimlessly spam at a flag, so if you were anticipating this... That's definitely not it. And although I can't guarantee anything, I'd be willing to bet that as soon as you start using it, your reaction will purely just be, oh, okay, I guess that exists. When it comes to how the map's played, nobody cares about this flag, or this flag, so you can pretend that they don't exist, because everything is happening at Flag Cupcake and Flag Dorito. Although there are a few minor exceptions, if you cap and hold these flags, you'll probably win the game. Plain and simple. Obviously, there are millions of different ways to cap these flags, but I personally enjoy slapping on a mask, marinating myself like a chicken breast in chlorine gas, sitting on an ammo box, and tossing 18 nades until I can't feel my triceps anymore. Yeah, please tell me of an easier way to cop yourself over 2,000 points in under 30 seconds with little to no effort. With the one exception of just being that rando that spawns in, pops one AT shell at the train that happens to take away the last sliver of health and receives all of the credit, including the six-man multi-kill without any of the hard work or effort.
That was unprofessional! Even for you.
Another item you should definitely know about is the fog, which is nothing short of abundant, and it always happens to pop in at the least convenient moments. Like, oh, you just hopped in a deadly seat on the train? Fog. You just got yourself in the heavy cannon seat of a bomber and are ready to tear objective Dorito in half? Fog. It does make everything close quarters because nobody can see shit, and sometimes you even benefit from the randomness while riding a horse.
And you about to get ran the fuck over.
Although I will take credit for that kill, riding a horse in the fog is just ridiculous. Like, you may as well just blindfold yourself. Speaking of horses, I had no idea that people got that affectionate and protective with them. Like, people are talking about naming their horse in chat? Like, what?
My horse's name is Nightmare.
Should've called it Butt Stallion.
That was taken.
And that's not the end of it. Like, sometimes it turns into real rage in all caps.
You slut, you took Seabiscuit.
I think it goes without saying that the only acceptable color of your horse is smoky black. Because if you choose bay or dun, you're pretty much outing yourself as a closeted light anti-tank grenade user, and nobody likes light anti-tank grenade users.
Stay down, asshole!
With that being said, here's your daily reminder that horses are horrifying, especially when they launch you off a flight of stairs, cut you in half in midair, and toss you over a fence. I'm a little surprised that more people aren't riding around in the good old MCJ sidecar more often. It's like I'm the only one that's discovered its killing potential and everyone else is ignoring it. Just Just be careful if you're trying to turn it into a minivan, because although it seats two comfortably, it seats three uncomfortably. That third passenger tends to fall through the earth sometimes, so just be aware of that. And I'm sure you guys saw that mounted heavy MG from the Giant Shadow trailer. That thing is actually not too bad. Recently, I've been embracing a variety of different mounted weapons, and although I'm planning on being sniped in the face eventually, usually the amount of kills or points that I can accumulate before that happens is totally worth it. But you will definitely notice that on both sides of the down behemoth, there's nothing but open fields where rookie snipers and riflemen that camp in buildings can punch holes in you like Johnny Manziel. Now, instead of trying to countersnipe or jogging your rain-soaked self over to the buildings where they camp, it's much easier just to bury them. Like, I think so many players are always looking for that perfect revenge kill when it's best just to crush them with debris. Like, it's so effective, it may as well be a coffin nail.
Multi-kill!
Another thing to be aware of are these things right here that look like minions. You know, minions. I think their similarities are awfully convenient because they both happen to be extremely toxic, but the only reason that I'm telling you this is to know to stay away from them.
Alright, I know this looks bad, but it's actually really, really bad. Please come help me out!
Yeah, something as weak as a saber swipe while you're on a horse is enough to set these things off. And before you ask, yes, you can get on top of the down behemoth, but in most cases, it's a poor plan because snipers always have their eyes peeled and you're heavily silhouetted against the dark gray color of the Zeppelin, so before you think that's the easiest way to rain death from above, say hello to the AT rocket shell entering your chest. I'm just happy that it's a down behemoth and not one actively floating in the air, because there's nothing that annoys me more than a Zeppelin coming crashing down and there's nothing you can do to avoid it. Oh my god, RIP everyone and everything that I've ever known. And that's about it. Be sure to tune in next time when we cut Clarence in half.